Okay, the last tool that I wanted to discuss was our CD mastering tool, which is Sony CD Architect. And it's actually a pretty simple tool, very intuitive. It's a drag and drop tool where you take your audio files, and you know, if you've used the Sony tools, you have this common set here. You have an explorer tool, which is a navigator, a trimmer, which lets you cut little pieces of your media, a thing called a media pool, which is an abstraction of the files in the project. And this master track list here, which is specific to the CD tool. So the master track list, that's the very important list of the files that you're using, and which are going to become the tracks on the CD by number. And the title, very accurately typed out as CD text, because if you play this back through a CD text compatible player, this text will actually appear on the screen. That's stuff you have to put in and be accurate about it. Position is done by the tool. It's kind of, you drop the file on here and you move it back and forth, and then that adjusts, as you can see, the position of the track and its start and end point. And the other thing here I wanted to show you is this ISRC code. An ISRC code is a special code that's assigned by a committee, ISRC. You have a country code, which in this case QM, which is a new code for the US. GPE is my business code. This is the year 14, and these are the tracks that I've done this year. And that's just a standard uniform identifier for digital tracks, no matter where they're at, if they're on CDs or an MP3. It's just a standard method, and once you register with ISRC, you don't have to re-register. So if you're in the business, you probably want to get an ISRC code. Companies like Audible will just do their own, and you never see it. So there's a lot of consumer tools that will do this same thing for you, that will do this mastering. But the nice thing about this tool is it does let you go through, it does the text, does the ISRC codes, and this case here, there's a fade in. This is, if you see that little, the little curved icon, that's the same fade in that you'll see in Vegas, the video editing tool. And there'll be a crossfade up here, is where I have two CD tracks that crossfade, and there's, you have to use a tool like this to do a crossfade. So a crossfade is where this track here is going to end. And you see, if I've done that right, I beat synchronized between the beat and the old track and the new track. It's really, really critical in CD mastering that you never hit 0 dB. So you have, this is also a volume thing here, and you can apply plugins too in here for mastering if you want. There are not as many effects, but you can, if you want, you can also manage volume with this envelope editing tool here, which is another common thing that's in most of the Sony tools, envelope editor. But usually what I do is I play through and I look to make sure that I never have peaks near zero. You can have a lot higher peaks on CDs than you can in MP3 coding, but when it clips, it's very harsh, and there'll be kind of a weird screeching sound in some pieces of equipment on some players, so you got to be careful about that. So here, by the way, this is an example where this track, the default I got set up now is a 2-second dead time between tracks, but I can override that by just shoving these guys together, or if I want to crossfade them, I'll just grab this thing and hello, and oh sorry, grab it up there and shove it over more. So it's pretty simple. And then when I'm done, what I'm going to do, other than saving the project, I'm going to export, I'm going to burn a disk. I'm going to burn an image. And when I burn that image, what I'm going to do, very importantly, is I'm going to not have buffering on, and I'm going to burn it really slow. I'm going to use a really slow burn speed. It's probably telling me to put a CD in there because I don't have one. And I'm going to do it at a slow setting, like 4 times or 8 times, and I'm going to turn off buffer underrun. So I'm not going to have this on. And the reason for that is that if I have this buffer unrun protection, sometimes you actually get error bits coded into your disk image because CDs have error correction. But I don't want to have any error bits. I want to have a totally exact dead-on disk image that I burn, so I'm going to turn that off. I'm going to make sure I write CD text also. So, and the burning, it's important to read the instructions that come with CD Architect and make sure that you burn nice and slow and you never run out of the buffer, you never run through your buffer. So, other than that, it's pretty straightforward.